many cream eggs is that, Yvette?
Many cream eggs? Ah, you used to eat them. They're very bad for you. They're very bad.
The cream egg king. Right, I want you to videotape me. Right, just point that at me.
Don't touch anything else, but...
All right, so just make sure I'm in it right in the middle.
Right, yeah.
Right, ask me any question you want. What question would you like to ask me?
What do you think the state of the barrels is in? Do you think the barrels will ever get back to its own way again?
Or that's
do you think,
a great question.
Or do you think the barrel lands is finished?
Finito. Well, it won't ever get back the way it was, because everybody's deed that was here, the population, right? But it has got a future. I would like to fill all the gap sites in with entertainment type places, like picture halls, theatres, pubs, clubs, cafes, stuff like that, restaurants. So it doesn't actually need any more market space, it just needs the gap sites filled in a bit, but not with that paltry 3.5 million that's been touted to the local council. But we'll never get 3.5 million, that's just a fictitious figure. I think they said over 10 years that'd be enough to take the fucking rubbish away for the next 10 years. So why don't they just get the blankety blank checkbook out for the 300 million, considering they've spent £12 million in the one building at Bridgeton Cross, coming out of that Clyde Gateway money, which conveniently stops at the edge of the Barras in the Calton. So stick that in your pipe and smoke. Next question. That was a good first question.
I don't know, do you know any other ones?
And a light-hearted question.
Do you think people nowadays are as friendly as what they used to be, or do you think now they're more selfish and all for themselves? That's a light-hearted question.
Certain sections of the community are more for themselves, but certain sections are still just as friendly. It just happens to be maybe the nature of the lifestyle of the people in this city. Like, there's a... not so much the old-fashioned family values, but you have got lots of other nice, interesting, friendly people about. There's lots of nice students about that liven the place up a bit.
Do you know, think mum and dad keep some of them, but they get everything laid in a plate compared to the people that are thing we are having to go out and work their backsides off, and they can't rely on anything else except work for Sunday.
No, that might be true in England, because mum and dad has to pay for it in England, but see in Scotland, your poor student is just—it's just as easy for them to get into college and uni.
That's true.
As it is, well, rather than it is in England. So I know people who go to college who I reckon don't have much money, and their mothers and fathers won't have much money. So they're going to college to better themselves, so they can hopefully get a few quid to look after mum and dad.
Okay, that's us.
Okay, over now. I love to just see the question. I believe brilliant questions. Right, what question can I ask you now? Let me think, it's hard when you've got to ask a question, isn't it? I would put the question to you, or what do you think the future of the Barras is?
The way I look at things, at the future of the Barras at the moment is things are basically getting worse and places getting destroyed because there's so much piracy and certain things. People are not doing the right thing, but if they can... people can go back to the old ways they were when it was years and years ago, the things would get better. But highly unlikely that's going to happen, because the Barras is becoming a place called the Black Market now. So the Barras is not what it used to be. Still get the ones that do the right thing, but at the same time, there's a lot of things that can... we'll need money off the councils to invest into the proper things so they can build things to make the bar lands more useful again, try and get the customers in. Plus, people haven't got the monies that they used to have, so that's why the Barras has lost the amount of people that usually come here. The numbers have went down because a lot of people have seen that there's a lot of DVD people selling things they shouldn't be selling, and they're losing that attraction to the actual Barras lands. But
is that maybe what you're trying to say is that there's not so much old fashioned stock like the second hand furniture and bric-a-brac here? the way the barrage used to be.
Now, it's not what it used to be. A lot of places are just shutting down. They've not got the money to keep it. It's all to do with the money. People are struggling to try and make ends meet.
What about the competition, like card boot sales elsewhere and things like that?
That's true. I agree with that. It's another one. What's the name of that place?
Lochearn.
Lochearn now. I think that's kind of taken away a lot.
Who runs that?
That's
the city. It's the city council. So they promote their own markets, didn't they?
That's it. So it's taking the customer away from here as well. But there is one good thing. We had that woman that was down at the antique place down in Dumbarton Road. She was up here about a couple of months ago selling things for like charity. So there's always hope for the Barlands if that lady comes down. Obviously, she'll put a good word in and try and make things.
What was her name again?
Oh, I can't remember her name again. What is that woman's
name
again?
Fuck her names. Her name will come back to me. But I'll tell you what, she's got a proper. Her place is called the Great Western Auctions. And her name is Anita Manning.
So,
do you know she's actually got relatives for this area?
I don't know that.
Big James Fitzy Fitzpatrick, an uncle of mine actually, married my aunt.
Did he play for St Mirren,
though? No, that's a different. That's Tony Fitzpatrick with the big moustache. He does a lot of good youth work in the east end of Glasgow. I've met him. Anyway.
I'm going to need to head now.
Where are you off to?
I'm just going for a quick wander about, then I've got to head up, I've got to get home, and I'm going to the Saxon concert. But have a nice day today.
Excellent, enjoy yourself at the Saxon concert.
I will, I've not been to one this year.
Are you going to wear something different?
I'll just wear a Saxon t-shirt and that.
Is that all?
And a puma jacket and a pair of tunas
probably. It's the Saxons that are the downfall of this place.
No, it's a heavy metal.
No, I know the heavy metal band. The Saxons, the Sassanacs from the south of England that still run the fucking country.
Oh, aye, the Saxons are way back when they fought against the English at that time. Wasn't
that's right, but they've took over, the Anglo-Saxons.
Aye, there's a lot of places in there's a lot of places down in England where they're
actually
digging and
excavating. That's right. The type they're the Illuminati of today.
Aye.
The Sassanacs.
Aye, but they're virtually
finally
buckled on.
The
army's completely gone now, but...
No, the Queen's a Saxon.
In a different sense, I...
No, she goes to... she goes to all the heavy metal concerts. See you later.
See you later, Lauren. No, Saxon are actually a rock band, not a heavy metal. They're more of a kind of rockish band.
Aye.
Gone for about nearly 30 years.
Aye.
They were out at the time where Motorhead was.
Aye, they're not bad.
I mean, that's the problem.
Do you listen to them loud in the house on the hi-fi?
No, you
should
be all that, don't do it anymore now.
No.
Just listen to it now and again.
Fair enough.
The neighbours don't know what you think about.
That's that. I'll see you later, pal.
Celtic were winning 3-0.
That's 5-0 now.
What? Shut up, finished.
What was the score, Davey?
4-1.
Hey.
4-1.
You sure it wasn't a 5-1?
Oh, 4-1.
Right, okay, over and out, Davey.